This week in Fort Hood on Track, more troops come home, children experience pre-deployment processing, and Wild West Night is coming. Around the world or around post, you're watching Fort Hood on Track. Welcome to the show. I'm Jana Zepp. We've had a very happy season of soldiers returning from deployments at the Great Place. First, the 20th Engineers returned, then 3 Corps headquarters, and as Ron Morse reports, the 36th Engineer Brigade is the third Fort Hood unit to return in the past month.
The atmosphere is electric. For the Christmas family, this is Dad's third deployment.
I'm really excited, but this deployment was hard. And I don't know what made it so difficult, but it was hard. And then one good thing is that we did get to talk every day. So that helped.
Technology like Skype helps families keep in touch, but there's nothing like holding a loved one in your arms. A year apart can strengthen that bond.
I just miss the time we spend together and we're all around each other and we're just a family, we talk and stuff like that. It's really fun.
Kathy has a surprise for her husband.
We got a puppy yesterday, and he knows that we was getting it, but he doesn't know that it's at the house. And him and my boys, they've been asking for a dog for years, so it's at the house waiting for him.
I think he's gonna be like just, oh, you finally got what you wanted, a dog, but you're gonna have to take care of it. He's gonna lecture me, responsibility.
The buses pull up, and the crowd is ready to see their soldiers.
I'm really excited, but I'm like kind of trying to hide it just because, you know, just save it for when he comes back so that way I can just a big burst of energy. But right now I'm just really excited.
After a quick uncasing of the unit colors, the rest speaks for itself.
All right, good job. God bless America. God bless the engineers.
From Fort Hood, Texas, I'm Ron Morse, 3 Corps Public Affairs.
Maneuvering through the deployment process can be a bit scary for spouses and sometimes traumatic for adolescents. Angie Malone has the story of how children got a firsthand account of what their parents have to go through right before they go off for a deployment.
Kids from 3 to 18 years of age were assigned to a platoon and lived life as a soldier for a day during a mock deployment at Comanche Chapel.
We bring our kids and we take them through the SRP sites, the soldier readiness processing, that gives them an idea of what their parents go through when they get ready to deploy.
Deployment specialists with ACS say that having the youth participate in this type of experience enables a sense of ownership in the deployment process.
I just wanted them to feel a little more at ease with the deployment that's coming up and just have fun, make some memories with Dad. Dad's here too.
Mary enrolled all 4 of her kids in the activity, including her 10-year-old son, Charles. Their family is facing deployment for the first time.
Helps me understand why my dad is leaving, to help fight to keep the youth safe and have freedom.
We bring our kids and we take them through the SRP sites, the soldier readiness processing, that gives them an idea of what their parents go through when they get ready to deploy. We take them through mock shots, mock dental, the mock eye charts. They get an in-country brief on Iraq and Afghanistan. They go through an obstacle course. They go through a road march.
The over 200 kids that signed up for mock deployment not only endured physical activities, they also learned about cultural differences.
We talk about the differences in the culture, the language, some of the words that they might be using over there, how there's sometimes the difference between the male and female, especially in the culture. We had all kinds of good questions. They ask, is it hot over there? Is it cold over there? And they do ask, even though we have pictures, where do they shop? Probably the best question was, how many people are over there? which is, you know, a really good question, and it's changing all the time. So, and they don't think like we think. So that's why we try to bring it down to their level, and then again, maybe help them understand a little bit more what the moms and dads are going through.
More than 25 agencies volunteered to make this exercise a reality. The operation ended when the soldiers left their respective platoons and were reunited with their families safe and sound. Reporting from Fort Hood, Angie Malone, 3 Corps Public Affairs.
A soldier's physical fitness numbers will soon be included as part of results given after taking the online global assessment tool. The GAT is part of the Army's Comprehensive Soldier Fitness Program that measures a soldier's fitness in 4 of the 5 dimensions that the CSF program focuses on, which are emotional, social, family, and spiritual. Brigadier General Rhonda Cornum, director of the Comprehensive Soldier Fitness Program, said it will also give a physical score because it will be linked to physical training test scores and Public Health Command health assessments. The 5th aspect of fitness measured by CSF is the physical dimension. Cornum said there was no date yet for the inclusion of the new information in the GAT, but that such things such as a soldier's PT score and wellness assessments, including body fat, lipids, and blood sugar, might be included. As February draws to a close, so too does African American History Month. John Miller was in Cav Country to see how they celebrated the occasion.
Each year, the nation recognizes the month of February as African American History Month, a time to reflect on the contributions and deeds of African Americans throughout the nation's history. Fort Hood has joined the nation in recognizing the contributions of African Americans throughout this country's history by hosting observances throughout Post.
This month, and just not the month of February, is very important for Black history, and to talk about the struggles that we went through in the previous years in the 1800s and the early 1900s and how far we've come as not just a race or culture, but as a people and as a nation as well.
Revisiting the accomplishments of African Americans traces the struggles they have fought for to secure our nation's freedom while still fighting to secure their own.
We're celebrating the achievements of African Americans, their struggles, what they've come through, and how they've contributed not just to our history, but to our military. And that's the point that people need to take away from this. You know, I heard Dr. Sissons there at the end, you know, one of the things that strikes me is says, you know, hey, we are American soldiers. That's what we have in common. And we are standing shoulder to shoulder, and we have fought wars together, as we do today, shoulder to shoulder. There is no difference. So, it obviously it hurts me and it angers me to see as a nation and even as a military sometimes we've not come as far as we think we have. And that hurts me because everybody here to me is my brother and sister, and we fight shoulder to shoulder. And we have done that, and we're going to continue to do this to make this great nation go on.
The contributions, sacrifices, and struggles of African Americans who are fighting for freedom laid the groundwork for the liberties that all Americans enjoy today. Reporting from Fort Hood, I'm John Miller.
Fort Hood gathered to honor the folks that make the great place greater every day. We went to the quarterly Hood Heroes Luncheon to meet them. Once a quarter, Fort Hood honors those who honor the Army with their service, whether civilian, soldier, or volunteer. Awards were given for team and individual efforts.
A couple of attributes I think are important and clearly consistent across the people we're going to recognize today. And the first one is they're extraordinarily loyal. They're loyal to soldiers, they're loyal to family members, they're loyal to community, and most importantly, they're loyal to helping all of us not only continue what we do in our hard business every day, but always, always trying to be better. And they're consistent in that loyalty. It never wavers, it never falters. It's just here all the time. Sometimes perhaps we take it for granted. But clearly, they're extraordinarily loyal to soldiers, family members, and mission.
Among the teams recognized was the Fort Hood Police Department for Team of Excellence. Among the individuals recognized was Sharon Ware for Special Brigade Volunteer, 41st Fires Brigade. Top Directorate Award went to the Directorate of Plans, Training, Mobilization, and Security Plans and Operations Division.
I helped the soldiers to get packed up and help, and we also sent care packages to them who's out there in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Brigades, battalions, and other organizations, as well as individuals all over the installation, were recognized.